You may see some syntactical use in our examples that it doesn't seem to make a lot of sense sometimes. I'd like to explain some of these. Most of these are just anomalies in Visual Basic, so let's go over them briefly. First of all, sometimes you'll see our methods are being used like functions. Sometimes they're being used like subroutines, and you can actually make them work either way. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Let me add a brand new display, and I'll just add a little subroutine to change the timestamp on this pie trend. It's one of our sample tags. I'll go into the Visual Basic Editor by pressing Alt F11. And here's one example of such an odd syntax. I'm going to go and on that object, this is the trend object, I'm going to do a set time range. And when I do a set time range, as you can see, by looking at the IntelliSense, if you can just see that there, this is returning a Boolean value. So if I were to do a set time range of, say, asterisk minus 4 days to the current time, then technically that's going to return a value. And when you return a value, then typically you expect to use it as though you were using a function. And in Visual Basic, functions, well, they have some certain characteristics. Let's go over those real quickly. If I were to do this as a function, I would want to set up some variable, first of all, to take the result. Let's dim x as a Boolean. And then I would say, okay, let's look at the result of this function. Let's say x is equal to, since we know this returns a Boolean value, we're going to say x is equal to the result of this. And when you use a function in Visual Basic, you have to put the arguments in parentheses. Now that's why in some of our examples, sometimes you'll see it looking like this, sometimes you'll see it looking like this. And in fact, it has no difference that I can figure out. Now, I've been all over Microsoft's website trying to figure out why they've decided to use this convention using functions or functions requiring parentheses and procedures not. Procedures, of course, don't return a value, so a procedure, it basically does not have to be assigned to anything. Let me just demonstrate that this is going to work just fine in both instances. Actually, I'd better give this a name. Let's call this test2. I'm going to go ahead and take my code and put that into test2. And let's go ahead and run this, and you'll see it works just fine either way we run it. Right now I've got an 8-hour time range. I'll go ahead and run test2, and now I've got a 4-day time range. Okay, I'll revert back to the 8-hour time range. Let's change the code. And as you can see, this works just fine as well. No problems. We'll go ahead and run this. Yeah, exact same result. So I suppose the moral here is, if you are going to be, a well-behaved programmer and you want to actually interrogate the results of your functions, then you should probably always use these as functions, and as functions you should use parentheses like that, and then have some kind of an if-then statement, you know, if x equals false, you know, then tell the user there's something that went wrong. Oh, and incidentally, if you omit these, of course you'll get an error message from Visual Basic. It is enforcing that rule of using functions, or functions requiring parentheses around the arguments. Second thing you may notice is that sometimes we omit the item method in our examples. You get examples off of a developer's network or in the books that we ship with the software. You'll see sometimes, well, in many cases, we use the item method in things like the symbols collection. Other times, we don't use the item method. There's a real simple explanation for that. The default property, or excuse me, the default method of any collection is the item method. Now, since that is the default, if you omit that method, it ends up becoming just the default. So you see a lot of VB programmers who just simplify things by saying it's called symbols1, not symbols item1. I just don't trust that one day Microsoft won't change the default method from item to something else. That's probably an exaggeration, but it's happened before that defaults get changed. I always think it's a better, just a more conservative method to always explicitly define everything and not rely on the defaults, because the defaults can change. There is no guarantee that the defaults are going to persist from one revision to the next.